welcome to Tech to Tech presented by KYZEN, where we will explore common cleaning questions and answers. Let's get started. I would like to introduce KYZEN's own Eric Bromley.
Thank you, William, and welcome everyone. Thank you for joining today's Tech to Tech session. Today we're going to talk about the cleaning no clean flux and paste. This is going to be a short history of the no clean products. It's actually part one of a six-part topic that we've broken up into some different subtopics that we thought were worth giving special time to. So I'm going to be talking about just the basics of how no clean came about. And then as you see, my other counterparts will be doing different segments as well. And the dates are also listed. So we encourage you to please sign in and join in for these tech to tech sessions as well, because they'll be very informative and very interesting, to say the least. So in the beginning, there was rosin-based RMA, which is rosin mildly activated. Those were the two real leaders in the flux paste world. And there was also liquid fluxes that were used for benchtop and wave solders and things of that nature. And also at that time, it was primarily through-hole processes with wave soldering. There wasn't any, very little, if any, surface mount technology at this time. And they had pretty much standard refro profiles for what little SMT was being done at that point. The fluxes and pastes back then, and with the no clean as well, they do have a lot of things in common. The bonding materials that are used, they're basically waxes and suspension materials that hold everything together while it's in the raw form. There are activators that are built into these fluxes that will prep the solder pad surface as well as the lead. The activators will clean the surface for good adhesion of the solder paste. And the solder paste itself has different size spheres. And when I say spheres, it's basically the solder balls. You can get them all different sizes and different materials. There are many, many different types and different materials to choose from. All of the solder paste providers do a really great job of having a full breadth of offerings. And then the liquid flux is used primarily for wave soldering. The old days when they had foam fluxers and wave fluxers, where the bottom of the printed circuit board would actually pass right over the top of these foam or wave fluxers on a belt and then go through preheat and then solder. And then it'd be a blow-off knife. That's really what has been superseded by the reflow oven now, but that was how it was years ago. And the liquid flux is also used for any hand soldering applications, and it doesn't have any solder spheres in it. It's only the activators. Over the last 10 or 20 years, there's been a lot of improvements and changes to the technology. The PCBs themselves are getting much smaller. The spacing between the pads, as we all know, is getting almost non-existent. They're getting more and more material on smaller and smaller surfaces. There are many more low or flush mounted components now than there were before. There was a time when everything had a very large standoff and it had really very few leads on it for soldering, but all of that has changed, as we are well aware. And because of all these changes, cleaning itself had become a challenge. It was then, and it is today, difficult to get in and around and under these components to adequately clean them and also adequately rinse them and dry them. So the entire process is a challenge. So that was really where the idea of not cleaning at all was introduced. So what is no clean flux and paste? What does that basically mean? So the theory is that after reflow, trace amounts of non-corrosive residues on or around the solder joint remain. And what that basically means is that the material that is left is doesn't need to be cleaned. That's the story anyways. So the saying is that if it's difficult to clean, just use a no clean and leave it. Now, from us, KYZEN, on the cleaning standpoint, we don't feel that that is really the best method to deal with these. Going to a no clean flux and a paste, it requires that you need to change the reflow process, because there are different spike profiles that are required for a no clean flux. And I'm speaking in general terms. There are many, many different fluxes and pastes on the market that may or may not need this, but for generally, there are some changes that are required. It prints a little bit differently because of the different blending agents that are in the material. They're designed to be left on the board after reflow, so they're not as aggressive as some of the rosin and the RMA type pastes. It wets out differently as well. So after the print process, if the solder paste is left on the board for an extended period of time, in some cases it can kind of flatten out or slump, if you will, to go off the pad a little bit. And again, this is generally, it's not every single one is like this. And the solder joint appearance itself, it will be different. If you're used to looking at an RMA flux or an RA flux, then water soluble, the flux and the paste is going to look a little bit different. So the reality of what no clean flux and paste is that the process should have been called low residue or low solids. And that's in our opinion. Basically, the no clean aspect just means that leaving this in place will not damage the board. But in fact, many processes are still cleaning no clean. Multiple customers that KYZEN have switched to a no clean process, yet they're still cleaning. And this is because of they need to conform a coat, or they have to do post-inspection, or there's cosmetic reasons, or there's longevity reasons, or they're being potted. There's a lot of different reasons why we believe that you still need to clean a no clean. And more and more of our customers are finding that out as well. And in addition to not cleaning off the flux and paste residue, there's also some latent chemicals from the board manufacturing process itself. When they build the layers of the bare boards and when they're sent to the customer, they're not cleaned after they're built and packaged up. So there's chemicals that are on the board surface that are remaining from that process that really should be cleaned off. There are small threads from the PCB dicing process when they actually cut the boards. They'll build the boards in 6 or 8 panel up, and then they dice them to your specific size. And in that process, some small threads will come off, and it may not seem like much, but if they were to redepose on a circuit or in a switch or in some kind of a thermal device, there's always the risk of a failure. Soils from the component suppliers itself is also another area that really is many times overlooked, but is very important. The different components that are placed on your board from the pick and place machine, those components themselves can have some soils on them. They could be an oil or a part marking or some kind of a lubricant that was put on them, or the suction cup itself from the pick and place machine, if not properly maintained, can leave residue on the components, which in turn will be basically entrapped on the part from the flux residue that's being left, the no clean flux residue. And then there's the always ever-present fingerprints. And this is not just fingerprints, but little pieces of hair and little pieces of skin. If people are using, they're not using gloves when they're handling the PCBs. And then there's always the atmospheric moisture and sneezing and just the moisture in the air and contact dirt from when people walking past the assembly benches. There's a lot of things that may not seem like much, or they're not visible to the naked eye, but they very much play a part in getting the printed circuit boards completely clean. And as I said earlier, there's more details on these topics in the upcoming tech-to-tech sessions. So I do encourage you to join these different sessions and learn more as we go along. And we'll be covering these different topics in much more detail. So some of the frequently asked questions that we get regarding no clean fluxes and pastes is, does no clean mean I no longer need to clean my PCBs? Well, our opinion is that is not correct. We feel you really should clean your PCBs because of the aforementioned issues that I had talked about, the different soils that are on these boards. Can I conform a coat over no clean residues? Well, the solder paste manufacturers of the no clean products, they say you can, and I guess technically you can, but it really, we don't recommend it, because you wouldn't want to put a conformal coat over a dirty surface, because there would be adhesion issues and there's a chance it could flake off, and there's other concerns where the conformal coat could somehow react with the no clean residues. Yeah, we don't think it's a good idea. You wouldn't wax your car before you wash it, so it doesn't make any sense that you would conform a coat over dirt, over residues. Can I clean the no clean residue with water only? No, you cannot. There may be some water soluble no cleans, but it doesn't make any sense. If it's no clean, then why would it be water soluble? And the no clean residues typically do not come off with water only. They will need a chemistry along with some temperature and some impingement energy to completely clean the residues from the PCBs. And finally, can I use RMA and no clean fluxes together on the same PCB? Yes, you can. We have many customers that will build a majority of the printed circuit board using an RMA process. And then there may be some components that require to be hand soldered after reflow and after cleaning that can't see either the higher temperatures or the fluids from the different washing processes. And those are typically hand soldered using a no clean flux, and then they don't reprocess or reclean them. So that concludes my topic here of the history of no clean fluxes and pastes. And thank you very much for your time. And with that, I will hand it back over to William.
Thanks, Eric. And thank you guys for tuning in to this Tech to Tech session. If you would like to discuss this topic further or have any questions not answered in the session, please contact your local KYZEN regional manager or send an email to tech2tech@kyzen.com, and we will have someone follow up with you as soon as possible. Do you want to have exclusive access to future content sent directly to your inbox, or do you know someone who would benefit from these sessions? If the answer is yes, just go to tech2tech@kyzen.com, fill out the subscription form. And if you like this video, be sure to follow us on our social media platforms for more expert cleaning content.